everyone, and welcome to my channel, The Veg Home Mama with Denise. I'm here today just to talk to you about what do you do when your child does not want to have school? What do you do? Well, I make my kids have, not make them have, but we have Life Skills Day. You may be asking, what is Life Skills Day? Pretty much, life skills are things that your kids need to know. Independent things, that's what I call them. Things that they need to know once they leave your house. Yes, once they leave your house. This is my youngest son, Tyson.
Hello.
He's here. He's one of the ones. Some days he wakes up, Mom, do we really have to do school? And I'm like, yes, you do have to do school. School is very important. So what are some things that I would like for my kids to know regarding life skills? One of them is how to go grocery shopping. Yes, see his eyes? Yes, he understands how to go grocery shopping. Now, how you may be asking, how can I make it, if they're not having school, how can I incorporate school in grocery shopping? Well, there are several ways. One way when you go grocery shopping is adding. You can have one of your kid or children, however many kids or whatever you want to, how many you would like for to the do. Well, with that said and done, you can have one of your kids be the counter. I know we have technology now. We have calculators. You can put them in charge of your smartphone, or you can do it like I like to do sometimes, old school it. Use your calculator on your cell phone or use a regular calculator. It's all up to you. With that said and done, use a calculator. You can have them add up all of the items that you have and put a sales tax on it as they input the information into your calculator. Also, besides that, besides adding your items up, they can also subtract. If you get something and they happen to throw something in your buggy, as we know kids always do, you can always say, no, mama's not going to buy that today, or daddy's not going to buy that today. And you can have them take that item out of your buggy, and if they happen to sneak a little adding into it, you can have them subtract that from your budget. With that said and done, besides having addition included and subtraction, you can also include multiplication. If you're going to the store and you may be a family of four or more, you know you have to buy more than just one item from the store. And with that said and done, you're going to have to multiply how many. Like, say for example, you get a box of $3.25 times you need four boxes of them. That's where multiplication come into play. And they can figure that out and they can input that into your into the calculator. Or if you have a child who loves mental math, they can do it mentally and keep up with it. Besides addition, subtraction, and multiplication when grocery shopping, the second way you can apply life skills is laundry. Laundry day. Yes, my child right here, Tyson, he knows all about laundry day. Every Friday or either Saturday, depending on how our work week goes, or our school week goes in this case, is laundry day in our household. Yes. So on laundry day, he is responsible for doing his own laundry. Now you may be asking, how can I incorporate school into laundry? Well, simple. If you use the dry detergent, you can measure it out. You can have your student measure the detergent out if you want to do it like that. If you use the pods, you can have them do phonics. Or in this case, if they're a little older, reading, by reading the back of the laundry box and have them look at the pods and determine how many pods they should use with their load of laundry. That's the second way. So you can add, you can use math with it to measure it. You can use phonics with it to read the back of the label. And also another way they can use phonics with their clothing. Some clothes we purchase, you cannot put them in hot, correct? Like my son said, you have to have it on a hot setting, or you may have to have it on a cold setting. So you have to make sure you read the back of those clothes. And then there are those clothes that you purchase that can be washed, machine washed, but you must hang them up to dry or dry clean only. So it's very important that your kids also read the labels. That's how you can apply math, and that is also how you can apply phonics too. All right, besides grocery shopping and doing laundry, another way is one thing that cooking. My youngest does is cooking. Excuse me, everyone. With cooking, you can also add math. math, they have to measure dry ingredients. They have to also measure the wet ingredients. Depending on what the recipe requires, it may require dry and wet ingredients. And also, how you can apply school with cooking is reading. Yes, reading. My youngest right here, Tyson, he's my future chef right here. He's an inspiring chef. His dad is a self-taught chef. And Tyson, he loves being in the kitchen. Some days he's in the kitchen with my husband. Some days he's in the kitchen with me. And he loves preparing dishes. I will also share videos of Tyson from time to time preparing little simple meals that your kids can also prepare for you to kind of save you from having to cook on a daily basis. Or just give them an opportunity to be in the kitchen and applying some math, some phonics, you know, building those skills outside of the classroom. Life skills, once again. All right. Another thing that you can also do is, besides laundry and grocery shopping and cooking, is housekeeping skills. Yes, I said it, housekeeping skills. One way for housekeeping skills is you can have them go and vacuum, or tell them the number of rooms you may have in your house, and have them vacuum their room. It requires a little bit of reading depending on what you're using to clean up with. They may have to, you know, read the back of the label of the furniture polish, or they may have to read the back of a label of if you just got a new vacuum and they want to put it together, that type of thing. And another way you can apply life skills when your kids do not want to go to school, or not go to school, but if your kids do not want to have school, it is by mowing or cutting, mowing your lawn. Yes, see how my youngest is looking? That's why. Because of the fact that he also has to get out there and mow the lawn.
Even on a hot day.
Yes, but on the hot days, we have him do it early when it's not as hot. But you know, it's summer now. And we are in South Carolina. These days get quite hot before lunchtime. So we normally have them get up early and do a morning lawn. You may be asking, how can I include school there? Well, one way is geometry. They got to know how to cut, hopefully, see my eyes, hopefully in a straight line. That's one way you can apply. Another way that you can apply life skills is, give me another one, son. Another way you could apply life skills is
making a bed.
That's housekeeping. Your housekeeping. That's life skills. That's something that you need to know. Hopefully,
woodwork.
You know how to pretty much make your bed, vacuum if you have carpet in your house, vacuum your floor. Those are little things that you can teach your kids. And once they become young adults, they know how to be independent and do those things. Cooking, cleaning, mowing the lawn. Those type of things are very important. Those are the life skills. And also grocery shopping. Because grocery shopping helps them with their schoolwork. But it also saves the parents. Because once they're able to drive, you can send your kids to the grocery store. And you get to enjoy some me time or couple time, depending on how you want to use your time while your kids are gone. Another thing you can do with life skills is one of things that my husband loves to do, woodworking. If you like working with your hands, building things, then woodworking is, you know, that's something that you can do. You can teach your kids, what's some things you learned with your dad? You can teach your kids
angles.
So math is involved. Here we go. We have angles involved.
Reading
is involved. Depending on what you are building, you must read the instructions and make sure that you build it successfully. Also, besides math with measuring and reading with woodworking, you also must know the safety skills. You must know your safety skills. You must know how to use the equipment. So that's another reading portion of it. You must also have your safety glass. So you need to know the proper techniques to make sure that you do not injure yourself while doing woodworking. And my youngest here and my oldest, Tyron, they help their dad with woodworking. And they have a blast. You know, I even go out there from time to time being mom, you know, go out there and help my husband. And I enjoy being out there working with my hands. It takes me away from the classroom and allow me to apply life skills somewhere else. Okay, back to my main video. What do you do when your kids do not want to have school? Well, three things that you can do. One, grocery shopping. Second thing that you can do, is you can do grocery shopping, cooking. You can do cooking. You can do woodworking. You can also take it in housekeeping. Housekeeping. You also do maintenance. Kids want to, you know, want to go out there and teach them a little bit of shop in your homeschool curriculum. Teach them how to change brakes. Teach them how to change the oil in your car. You know, just the little simple things. Those are things once they become young adults and leave your home, they know how to do. And also one important thing, how to change a tire. Because there's one day you may get a flat tire and need to change your tire, because believe me, roadside assistance takes a while to get to you here. So if something happens to break on your car, it is really nice to know how to repair it yourself if you can. Because roadside assistance takes a while. And those are some things that I wanted to share with you today. What should you do when your kids do not want to have school? Those are some little tips that I can give you on what I do when my kids do not want to have school. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel, The Veg Home Mama with Denise. During these times, please stay safe. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.